morning students. Today we are going to see unit 19, origin and evolution of life. Unit 19, origin and evolution of life. Last video we saw the same unit in the variation, paleobotany, fossilization. In this video we are going to see determination of age of fossils, ethnobotany and astrobiology and exobiology. Let's see one by one in detail. First one, determination of age of fossils. The age of fossils is determined by radioactive element present in it. Inside the fossil, radioactive elements are present. The elements are carbon, uranium, lead or potassium. It is used to paleobotany or anthropology for determining the age of human fossils and manuscript. Radioactive carbon C14 dating method. This method was discovered by W.B. Libby 1956. The consumption of carbon of animals and plants stopped after the death. Since then, only the decaying process of carbon-14 occur continuously. This time passed since the death of the plant or animal can be calculated by measuring the amount of carbon-14 present in their body. The animals or plants continuously consuming the carbon. After death, they will stop the consumption of carbon. Only decaying process, the carbon-14 is present. The time calculated how much carbon is present. According to this, the age of fossils we can calculate. What is the time scale? Geologic time scale. The geological time scale is the system of chronological dating that relates geological rock strata to time and used by geologists, paleontologists, the other earth scientists to describe the time, timing and relationship of event they have occurred during the earth history. Thiruvakkarai Fossil Wood Park. It is situated in the Viluppuram district near Kadalur. 2 million years ago, the tree trunk, bark of the tree, that got buried along the river. In course of time, long time, the organic matter was replaced by silica and was fossilized. They retained the color, shape, texture and was converted into solid rock. The piece of rock is look like a real rock, but that is not real. It is replaced by the silica. The annular ring, the texture, color of the layer, notes of and every properties of plants are still visible, that converted as a rock-like structure. This is the best example of infiltration and replacement. Next, ethnobotany. Ethnobotany is a study of a regional plant. The practical use, the traditional knowledge, the local culture of the people, traditional knowledge, for example, grandma treatment. The term ethnobotany was coined by J.W. Hasberger. This is the ethnobotany. They are giving treatment with the help of traditional local plant. That is traditional. Through the discipline excitement for the age, ethnobotany emerged as a distinct academic branch of natural science in 20th century. This is coined by J.W. Hasberger. Aspects of ethnobotany. Ethnobotany has relevance with the problem of nutrition, health care and life support system, faith in plant, cottage industries, economic upliftment, conservation of biodiversity and sustainable use of plant resources. So these are the aspects of ethnobotany. Importance of ethnobotany. Ethnobotany provides the uses of plants. Traditional uses of plants. Traditional means from our old parents, from our grandparents, that is traditional use of plants. It gives information. The ethnobotany gives information certain unknown and known plants uses. The ethnomedicinal data. Ethnomedicinal data will serve as a useful source of information for the chemist, pharmacologist and practitioner of herbal medicine. That is Siddha Ayurveda, they are following the ethnobotany. Tribal communities, those who are living in the mountains, that communities utilize ethnomedicinal plant pots like bark, stem, root, leaves, flower bud, flowers, fruits, seeds, oil, raisins, dyes, gum for the treatment of disease like diarrhea, fever, headache, diabetes, jaundice, snake bites, leprosy, etc. The ethnobotany is a valuable one. Astrobiology or exobiology. Are we alone in the universe? If your answer is no, then how do we detect the existence of life in the space? Astrobiology or exobiology is the science which looks for a presence of extraterrestrial life in the universe. Extraterrestrial life means still some scientists believe that all organisms are arising from different planets including Earth. Astrobiology deals with the origin, evolution and distribution of life in the universe and to investigate the possibility of life in other world. The major concept in astrobiology is the habitable zone. The theory explained that any plant can be support the existence of life if it fulfilled two important criteria. First one, it must have a right mass to retain an atmosphere, right in atmosphere. Second one, it must have an orbit at just a right distance from its star means sun, that it allowed the liquid water to exist. The distance need to be neither too hot or nor too cold and is often referred to Goldilocks zone, that is living area for life. Our solar system, Earth is only the planet in Goldilocks zone. The zone varies at the time the star evolves. We know Mars have also been habitable. The life on Mars luckily to be a creature, we find extreme environment on Earth. The organism which live in extreme environmental condition on Earth are called extremophiles. The organism live too heavy temperature or too heavy cold region also that organism can live, that is extremophiles. Within our solar system, there are many areas that are different from Earth, where it is probable to find the presence of life similar to extremophile bacteria. The bacteria can live any temperature. Thank you. Thank you once again.